There are many ways to saying hello, how are you? Let me show you how to say hello, how are you in several languages. Salam. Hale shama chet to us. Leho ma. Ni hao. Bao wel ni. Como se va? Como estas? Hello, how are you? There are many ways to saying hello, how are you? One of the benefits to being an ESL teacher as well as an ESL student is you have the opportunity to say hello, how are you in a variety of languages. One thing to remember as a teacher is you will be working with students from pretty much all over the world. So don't be surprised if you say hello, how are you, and they respond back to you in their native language. Now, why is saying hello, how are you so important? It is one of the most easiest and most comfortable ways of starting a conversation. It's also a way to help people feel comfortable because, again, whether you're a native speaker or not, saying hello, how are you can make a person feel nervous, even native speakers like myself. Sometimes you can walk into a room and there's so many people around and people are talking, whether they're speaking in English or whatever language they're talking, and you want to so much jump in and say, hi, how are you? But you're quite nervous. You're shy. You don't know what to say. Do I say hello to him? Do I say hello to her? What if I don't say it correctly? I don't know. I can't tell you how many times I have been to classes, I have been to meetings, conferences, where people are speaking and I so much want to be a part of the conversation and I freeze. Literally. I can't move. Same feeling that we may get as native speakers, imagine our ESL students. They feel just as nervous saying hello, how are you, whether it's to you as this teacher or to their classmates. So it's important, I would say, that as a teacher, you might want to learn a couple of phrases in the language of your students. Now, what I mean by this is I don't expect you to be fluent in all the languages of your students, because that can be quite difficult, unless you have a knack for languages. But hello, how are you? It's always a good way to start off a conversation, or at least help to break the ice a little bit. I have had the pleasure of learning different ways of saying hello, how are you, just off of meeting friends and students from around the world. When I was teaching, I was working with students from mainland China. Some of my students were Cantonese speakers and some of them were Mandarin speakers as well as Fujianese speakers as well. So although I did not know how to say hello, how are you in Fujianese, but I did know how to say in Cantonese, Lei Ho Ma, or if I was speaking to a Mandarin speaker, I would say Ni Hao. And don't worry too much if your pronunciation is off. I'm sure my pronunciation isn't the best either. But it's a way to help your students feel like, oh, she has an interest in my language. Sometimes that alone can help a student feel quite comfortable. If you are in a classroom and let's say you're looking around and realize, okay, I don't know the languages of any of my students, that's okay too. You might even ask them, can you say hello, how are you in your language? I can't tell you how many times I've done that, and students feel so comfortable because guess what? They're speaking in their native language, and they feel comfortable sharing this with you because they say, wow, my teacher's interested in learning my language? This is pretty cool. And they just might, in fact, do that. Now, later on in the lesson, you might, of course, incorporate that into maybe a lesson where you're doing conversation or maybe grammar or whatever the lesson you have planned for the day. But if you're just looking just to break the ice and kind of get people talking a little bit, even amongst each other, hello, how are you? You can't go wrong. Practicing informal English. So for example, if you say hello, how are you, that's very formal. Or you might say, hey, what's up, which is informal. That also can be a way to get students interested because, secret, a lot of students who are new to this country want to learn the formal and informal way of saying hello, how are you? Why? For a lot of students, they want to feel like they can adapt to the new country by speaking the same way as the people of that country. So for example, of course they would need to know how to say hello, how are you? But maybe they might be interested in, hey, what's up? And let me tell you this, one of the things I used to do in my classes when it came to informal English, I used to do a little body language involved. I would add in a little informal way of saying, hey, what's up? So for example, you could start off by just saying, hello, how are you? Or you could say, hey, what's up? And notice I did a little of this. You don't have to say, hey, what's up, or use your hands like this. That's totally up to you. But you know what? For the students, they're going to like that, because then they may feel comfortable talking to someone who may in fact go up to them and say, hey, what's up? And they can say, I'm fine, and you? And they might feel a little silly doing this, I understand, because this feels a little weird, like, why I have to do all this? And you don't have to. But let's face it, we don't talk like robots. We're not going to do like this and say, hey, what's up? I'm fine, and you? No one's going to do that. So don't be afraid to play around with this a little bit. But you don't want to focus solely on informal speech either, because the students need to know the formal way so they can understand the informal way. If they only understand the informal way, that's not going to be to their benefit, especially in situations where they're applying for a job or maybe they're asking questions to a professional. They can't go into a job interview and say, hey, what's up? I'm looking for a job, because that's not going to work. So be careful with that. So again, ladies and gentlemen, if you're feeling a little shy and you want to kind of break the ice, say hello, how are you? If you want to say, hey, what's up, feel free. Or you can simply say, lei ho ma, ba wao ni, ni hao, como sa va, or como estas. So have fun saying hello, and I will see you in the next video. Bye for now.